The Vancouver City Central Transmission Project is the most significant investment in Central Vancouver's electrical system in almost 30 years. The project will increase the reliability of the electrical supply throughout Vancouver and meet the growing demand for power in South False Creek and Mount Pleasant, which is expected to increase by almost 82% over the next 30 years. This project includes a new substation in Mount Pleasant, a new transmission line under city streets, and drilling and installation of the transmission line under the bed of False Creek. The 8-kilometer transmission line route goes through densely populated areas, including Mount Pleasant, Yaletown, and downtown Vancouver. Let's go through the stages involved in the transmission line construction. Early in the project, the crews began installing one of the 15 underground cable vaults required along the transmission line route. The cable vaults are installed in two precast pieces, and each half weighs about 47,200 kilograms. Construction crews also began excavating trenches in city streets to allow for installation of the transmission line concrete housing. The duct banks will house the new underground transmission line that will connect the new substation in Mount Pleasant with two existing substations in Vancouver. The new line consists of two cable circuits that are made up of three 230 kilovolt cables. Crews safely completed duct bank construction despite many challenges, including avoidance of existing underground utilities such as water pipes, sewer pipes, and gas lines, variable soil conditions that were addressed using geotechnical engineering solutions, and coordination with City of Vancouver projects to reduce overall construction impacts. A major part of this project was the creation of a crossing 30 meters under False Creek through horizontal directional drilling. The logistics and planning for BC Hydro and the construction crew was intensive, as the sheer scale and timing around the various stages proved to be very complicated. Between February and May 2011, construction crews at the David Lam Park worksite drilled a crossing under the bed of False Creek to the Laurel and West 7th worksite. During the drilling stage, the pipe bundle was taking shape along a railway corridor. 13.7-meter-long plastic pipes were fused into seven 850-meter-long pipes in an assembly area. Piece by piece, the pipes were fused, laid out, and put together in a bundle weighing 140,450 kilograms. The most intensive logistical stage within this project was the actual pipe bundle move through the streets of the Fairview Slopes area of Vancouver. Crews worked around the clock, moving the pipes through 10 city blocks in preparation for the bundle to be pulled through the pre-drilled crossing under False Creek into the worksite at David Lam Park. As this was the first time a pipe bundle of this number of pipes, length and weight, had been pulled through such a densely populated urban neighborhood, a number of unexpected technical challenges arose. The team needed to use innovative solutions to get the work completed. For example, as crews began to pull the pipe bundle into the crossing under False Creek, the bundle started to twist and progress was stopped one-third of the way into the crossing. Crews had to remove the temporary bindings, untwist the pipe bundle using forklifts, and lay the pipes directly onto the street to prevent further twisting. As a result, the pipe bundle pull took longer than the 4 days originally anticipated. This expanded construction schedule kept the project team busy as they worked tirelessly to keep over 11,000 residents and businesses in affected areas informed. After 7 intense days of moving the pipes with cranes, excavators, construction vehicles, and rollers, the pipe bundle was fully moved from the assembly area on the railway corridor to the Laurel and West 7th Avenue worksite. The pipe bundle was then pulled through the crossing under False Creek. This work took approximately 24 hours. After the bundle pull, grouting of the borehole took place to secure the pipes inside the crossing under False Creek. Once the underground cable vaults and duct banks were complete, the transmission cable could be installed. Crews installed the transmission cable into the underground cable vaults using a large crane and reel. Each reel of cable held on average 500 meters of transmission cable and weighed 20 tons. The transmission cable was then pulled through the underground duct bank to the next cable vault. Once all transmission cables have been installed, the sections of transmission cable will be jointed together inside the underground cable vaults. Construction of the VCCT project is expected to be finished in the spring of 2014, when the final component, the substation, goes into service. When completed, the project will ensure a continued, safe, and reliable supply of electricity in communities throughout Vancouver for generations.